Thank you to NordPass for sponsoring this episode. Welcome to Paragon's Favorite Stuff, where we show you all the things that we love to have aboard our 42-foot sailboat named Paragon. In today's episode, I'm going to show you our new watchkeeping alarm called the Aqua Alarm Last Watch 2. We'll unbox it, we'll install it, I'll show you how it works, and then we'll use it on our voyage of 210 nautical miles from the Faroe Islands to the Shetland Islands. Keeping an effective watch on an offshore passage can make all the difference in the world between having a successful voyage or a disastrous one. A watch alarm helps you maintain an effective watch by alerting the person who's on watch at regular intervals to do all of the things on a checklist. Over the past 18 years, I have always used a watch alarm called the Watch Commander. And over that time, it has proven itself to be an absolutely essential piece of safety gear. So much so that I wouldn't want to go offshore without a watch alarm like the Watch Commander. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like the Watch Commander is available for purchase anymore. There is another watchkeeping alarm product that is available for purchase today, and it's called the Aqua Alarm Last Watch 2. I contacted Aqua Alarm when I was looking for a backup for my Watch Commander. They did send me their product so that I could check it out and review it. I am hoping that it does just as good a job as the Watch Commander did. There's a lot more to keeping an effective watch on an offshore passage than just looking out for ships. There are also a whole bunch of other things that you might have to check on at regular intervals, like how your sails are doing, if you're still on course, how your engine's doing, if there's any water in the bilge, what's going on with the weather forecast, among a whole bunch of other things. And if you're single-handed, then it's kind of a whole different ballgame, because then you've also got to integrate rest into your watch. A key thing with a watchkeeping alarm is that if the person on watch falls asleep and doesn't hear the alarm, then after a short while, a second, much louder alarm goes off. And this second alarm is not only loud enough to definitely wake up the person on watch, but it's also loud enough to wake up everybody on the boat. And I think that in itself is an essential feature. Because if the people off watch hear that second alarm go off, then they know that there's a problem with the person who's on watch. When I'm off watch and down below, I get a lot of reassurance by not hearing that second alarm. That way, I know that the person who's on watch is okay and doing their checks. Here's the box that Aqua Alarm sent us. Let's open it up. This is the main unit. It's got a white wire and a gray wire. The gray wire is actually a duplex wire with a red positive and a black negative for hooking it up to 12 volt power. The white wire is for connecting it to the secondary alarm. More about that in a minute. There are a couple of keys which are used to turn the unit on, a red button which is used to reset the alarm, a digital countdown display, and this small alarm speaker. There's also this little red light here, which blinks when the alarm is going off. I think this watch alarm might be similar to what you would find on the bridge of a commercial ship, where the captain could use the key to set the timer interval and then activate the alarm and then take the key so that the bridge crew wouldn't be able to deactivate the alarm. Then the bridge crew would be responsible for hitting the reset button every time the alarm went off and doing their checks. There are two secondary alarms to choose from. One of them is this big red bell, which looks pretty cool. The other alarm is this siren, which also has a red flashing light. Both of these secondary alarms have a black cable for connecting to negative ground and a positive cable, which you connect to the white cable coming out of the main unit. You can mount either of these secondary alarms some distance away from the main unit, but for my installation, I've decided to install the siren and the main unit on this piece of plywood. I'll mount the plywood right here by the bulkhead with Velcro so it's removable. That way, we'll be able to bring it out into the cockpit and have it right beside us wherever we're sitting on watch. I'll mount the siren and the main unit onto the plywood. I will cut back the white cable coming out of the unit and the red positive cable coming out of the siren, and I'll connect them together using a heat shrink butt connector. Good. The power cable is 32 inches long. That's not long enough for how I'm going to be using it. So I'm going to replace it with this 96 inch long one. Be really careful not to cut the actual wire. I'll connect the negative from the siren to the negative from the unit and then to the negative in my power cable. I will heat shrink these. Looks pretty good. Next, I will wrap some self-amalgamating tape around the butt connectors to protect them even more. Good. I'll secure all of these wires to the plywood base using this cable tie mount and a cable tie. On the other end of our power cable, I put these two connectors so that we can hook it up to our circuit breaker, which is right here. And to access the breaker, you can open this door. There it is. Connect the positive to the breaker, which we'll use as a on-off switch. I'll hook up the negative cable to this negative wire right here. Great, we're hooked up to power. I cut out this little groove right here so that the wire can fit right there. I'm going to put some Velcro on the back and Velcro on the bulkhead, so I'll be able to mount it on the bulkhead when we're not using it and then detach it and bring it out into the cockpit when we are using it. And then on the bulkhead, I will use the stronger industrial Velcro. I think if I use the industrial strength Velcro on the plywood as well as on the bulkhead, then the Velcro would be so strong that I wouldn't be able to detach it too easily. But I think with the combination of the stronger industrial strength Velcro and then the much lighter weight Velcro, this may work. Okay, this will go right here. See if I can detach that. Yes, very good. So this is now going to live right there. And I can coil up this wire and put it inside the box. Now that it's installed, I'll show you how it works. We'll program in the number of minutes for the countdown. To do this, you press the reset button in and turn the key to the on position. Then, when you release the reset button, the digital counter display gets set to zero. You set the countdown interval by pressing the reset button until the desired time interval is set. Each time the button is pressed, one more minute is added. Then you turn the key to the off position, and the countdown interval is programmed in. Then, when you turn the key to the on position, the unit is activated and the countdown starts. The remaining time is always displayed on the digital readout. Even if you take the key out, the alarm stays active, and it can't be turned off without the key. So like I said before, I think some captains, especially on larger commercial ships, might set the timer and then take the key with them to ensure that their crew maintains an effective watch. But for us, I think we'll just leave it in the on position all the time, and then we'll use that circuit breaker switch to turn it on and off. Again, if you cut the power to it to turn it off, it still remembers what the time interval was set to before. Let's set the timer for just 1 minute. One. And then we'll activate the alarm. And when it reaches zero, we'll hear that first alarm. That's what the first alarm sounds like. It's definitely loud enough to get your attention in the cockpit, even if it's noisy with wind and seas and engine noise. When the alarm goes off, you just hit the reset button and it restarts the timer. If you fell asleep and you didn't hear that first alarm, then this is what happens. That second alarm is so loud, it's almost unbearable. It'll definitely wake up anybody in the cockpit that's asleep, as well as everybody else on the boat. So when the on-watch person hears that first light alarm, they're always in a big hurry to hit that reset button so that they don't have to hear the second alarm. I decided that for us, we'd use the siren with the red flashing light instead of the bell, but just so that you can hear what the bell sounds like, I'm going to hook it up to 12 volt power. I'm just going to use this little rig that I made. It's a 12 volt cigarette lighter plug, and on the other end, I've got these two alligator clips. We'll just plug this into our 12 volt cigarette lighter and then hook up the negative and the positive. I think I'll actually hook this bell up to our upper level high capacity bilge pump that only goes off if our lower level bilge pump has failed or can't keep up with the ingress of water. Our lower bilge pump has an alarm on it already, but the upper one doesn't, and I think this one might be perfect for that. Now we're going to sail 210 nautical miles from the Faroe Islands to the Shetland Islands, and we'll use the Aqua Alarm Last Watch 2 for the whole voyage to keep an effective watch. But first, let's say thank you to our wonderful sponsor for this video, NordPass. Thank you to NordPass for sponsoring this episode. Go to nordpass.com/drakeparagon or use the code DRAKEPARAGON at checkout for an exclusive offer on a 2-year NordPass premium plan.
Hey, Drake.
Yeah?
What's the password for Instagram?
Hey, Drake.
Yeah?
What's the password for Facebook?
Hey, Drake.
Yeah?
Can I get the password for Netflix?
Hey, Drake.
Yeah?
Before we take off, can I get the password for the Iridium Go?
You really should get NordPass.
What's that?
NordPass is an awesome password manager. With NordPass, you just have to remember one master password to log into any of your accounts on any of your devices. And NordPass has advanced features like identifying vulnerable passwords, generating custom complex passwords, and a data breach scanner to check to see if any of your passwords has ever been leaked. It's really easy to use and completely secure. Go to nordpass.com/drakeparagon or use the code DRAKEPARAGON at checkout for an exclusive offer on a 2-year NordPass premium plan. You were coming up on the first alarm. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I think maybe that's a little too loud. I think I'm gonna put something over the little speaker just to dampen it a little, because if I'm lying here, my head's right here, and that alarm's right there, it's a little too loud, I think. I don't think that's a problem, because I'll just put a little piece of foam over there. Got some scrap Armaflex insulation. I've insulated most of the hull with this stuff. It's got this adhesive layer on the back. You just peel the wrapper part off and then stick it on to whatever you want to insulate. I'm just gonna cut off a little square and put it right over the alarm, and then we'll see how that sounds. And I just glued it right on there. I can still hit the button and still access the key, still see the display. It looks fine. And we'll see what that sounds like in another 5 minutes and 53 seconds. 2, 1. Now that's more like it. Yeah. That's not too loud. That's perfect. Definitely loud enough so that you can hear it from anywhere in the cockpit, even if the engine's running or if it's really windy. It is now 10 minutes before 9. Sunset's at about 10. We'll have this going off every 10 minutes through the night, making sure that we scan the horizon, look at the radar, look at the sails, make sure that there are no obstructions that we have to worry about, no ships and etc. So here we go, we're on our way to Shetland. One kind of cool thing about a watch alarm like this is that you can reset it before it reaches zero and that first alarm goes off. So say for example, I've set this to go off every 10 minutes, but say 5 minutes has gone by and I get up and look around and check everything and everything's cool, then I can just hit the red button and then it starts counting down again from 10 minutes. So you don't have to hear that first light alarm all the time. You can hit the button at any point before it reaches zero and then just reset the counter. One really big deal about this is that if something goes wrong, anything goes wrong, I fall overboard or, you know, hit my head and go unconscious or who knows, something goes wrong and I can't hit that button, then within 30 seconds of the first alarm going off, the second alarm goes off and then everybody on the boat knows. So right now Mo is down below sound asleep, and if anything were to happen to me, she would know pretty quickly because the second alarm would go off and then she would be able to come out and, you know, figure out what happened. So it brings a lot of peace of mind having something like this. Regardless of how many crew you have, if you have one person on watch and everybody else is down below sleeping, then if anything goes wrong with that person on watch and they can't hit the button, everybody finds out about it pretty soon. And that could feasibly make all the difference in the world.